integrating technology with human evolution? Seems like such a good sell for man. You're building a better you. But the fact is, it's just simply not true.
Human augmentation.
Human augmentation.
Sarif Industries.
Rising deaths on the street.
This is a business that's driven by fear. If I don't improve myself, if I don't augment myself, then I'll be less intelligent, less capable, less strong than the rest of the human race.
Augmentation is a huge business for these corporations, and we're paying for it by sacrificing our humanity and freedom.
Violent clash.
Reports of human experimentation.
We have to ask the question, are we playing God?
We've been integrating ourselves with technology for decades now, replacing damaged limbs with mechanical limbs, implanting data chips into our bodies, which give away huge amounts of information to governments and corporations all across the globe.
At no point have they thought about the consequences of their actions. They actively encourage you to exchange your perfectly functional body parts for upgraded augmentations. What they are doing is ethically and morally wrong, and they should be brought to justice.
Growing numbers of people experiencing
today, Sarif Industries signed a new historic military deal.
I know that they are creating mass quantities of military-grade augmentations. I've seen testing on them, and it's very scary. Very scary types of alterations.
They want to systematically turn us into machines and pump us full of their drugs.
You have to take neuroxazine, one of the most dangerous and addictive drugs that exists in the world today.
You'll have to take this drug for the rest of your life. If you don't, your body will reject your augmentations. It's a drug that's priced so highly that we are now seeing cases of high-profile people who are now out on the streets, and they are begging. They are begging for drugs. They'll have their technology in your body. They could have the power to turn off your limbs, the potential to turn off your eyes. They'll be able to send messages to your brain and control your thoughts as if they have the power of God.
People have been abused, kidnapped, experimented on. Any kind of resistance or opposition is met with fierce and brutal terror on the people. When does this stop? When will you stand up and fight?
They are killing our humanity!
Is everything in place?
Almost.
What do you mean, almost?
I have spoken with Montreal. The broadcast satellites are ours when we need them. A few weeks of discomfort and the public will be primed for our recall.
And the clinics?
We control their purse strings. They will do as we say.
I still think we should wait for the referendum.
We can't afford to wait. America's Science Board convenes next month.
But the mood among the delegates is shifting. I'm positive that given more time...
No. By going public with this discovery, Sarif is forcing our hand.
The world will not change overnight just because David Sarif willed it. Besides, we can do nothing until our biochip is ready.
I thought you said you were close.
Finding the correct nerve interface has proven more challenging than anticipated. Fortunately, thanks to David, I now know where to look.
And in Washington tonight, crowds continue to gather in front of the Capitol. Most are demanding that Congress severely restrict efforts to alter the human body's abilities. This in response to claims made by biotechnology expert David Sarif that that his firm may have discovered a way to make human-controlled evolution available to all. Sarif Industries researchers are set to arrive in Washington tomorrow to defend their claim. But for tonight, this is Eliza Kazan reporting to you live.
With all due respect, Major, I'll expect two security details waiting for us on the tarmac. No, we won't be going through the terminal. It's too exposed. Yes. I'm glad you understand. Good night, idiot.
Something wrong?
No, not for me, it isn't. But you keep pulling on that necklace, Dr. Reed, and you're gonna break it. Come on, Meg. You've defended your research before.
That was different. Then it was all just theories. But this discovery, Adam? It's big. Kepler big. Rosetta Stone big.
So, what's the problem?
They'll want to know how I found it.
Megan, we're leaving for DC and... Adam, you're there. Good.
You need something, boss?
Yeah. I want to go over your security plans for Washington before we leave. You and your team ready to go, Megan?
Almost, David. We're just rechecking data.
Well, make it snappy. We have to actually be in Washington before you can dazzle all those federally appointed know-it-alls.
I hate it when he does that. Come on, I'll walk you partway.
Warning, this lab is for authorized personnel only.
What did you mean back there, Meg? About how you found it?
Nothing. It's just my nerves talking.
There's something I should know about this place, about Sarif.
Megan!
Hold on.
We're still getting biochemical fluctuations across the artificial flow cells.
Okay. But the increased neural peptides coming from the PDOT cluster could be throwing off your calibrations.
Right. I'll double check that.
I can't believe you were asking about David. You've been here long enough to know... Eric! You wouldn't be avoiding me, would you?
I wouldn't dream of it, Dr. Reed. I think I know why Declan's readings are off.
Too many peptides?
I'm thinking the glial tissue breakdown he noticed after splicing in the repressive protein might be the cause. If we had a better cytometer...
We might get a more accurate reading that confirms the theory. I'll ask David to consider it.
Well, if he orders one from Page Industries, maybe they'll throw in another cappuccino maker.
You overthink everything, Adam. The work we're doing is good. We're helping people overcome their physical limitations.
Yeah, except most of our clients seem to be DOD.
You're doing
it's
good.
Just
another hour to go.
Ah, Dr. Reed. This is General O'Neill.
Dr. Savchenko was telling me you've made progress on the typhoon.
Yes, thanks to Vasily, actually.
As I was saying, sir, the typhoon uses a modified combat chassis like the one I'm wearing. But I've improved its design using shaped microcharges to propel the steel balls.
And the backblast problem?
Solved through kinetic bleeders in the augment. Here, watch. Go ahead.
Impressive. How soon till it's ready?
I'm afraid I have to run, but Vasily has all the details, General.
Of course.
We still have some work to do.
You're right. The teacher would just love having one of those things.
You're missing the point. Defense contracts keep us afloat. But neural augmentations that make you think faster, react quicker, they can really improve a life. Everybody's lives. David's talked about it for years.
Yeah. He is a talker.
He's a good man. Admit it, Adam. A part of you likes him.
I like everyone, Dr. Reed.
Yeah, right.
How far are you going?
Diane's office. I forgot to leave her a key so she can walk Kubrick. He's gotten big, you know. Keeps knocking over all my plants.
Did you destroy that vase yet?
I moved it. And I fenced in the yard. Like you always said you were going to.
Yeah. Never got around to that. Sorry.
Me too. About a lot of things. Adam, there's something I...
Good evening.
Pritchard.
So, are we all ready for the trip?
There's Farida. I'd better hurry. See you at the helipad, Adam.
Sure.
Did I interrupt something, Jensen?
You fix that firewall yet?
You don't fix an entire firewall. You find the loophole and plug it.
Then did you plug it?
Yes, I did. Want to know how? Oh, wait, I forgot. Ex-cop. I doubt you'd understand.
Ex-SWAT, and you'd be surprised. Sarif has to see you too.
Athena. She wants me to show her how to track our scientist implanted locator devices. In case your security plans in Washington don't measure up.
They will.
Gentlemen, how wonderful to see you both. Go right in, Adam. He's waiting.
This is the newest in encrypted GPL trackers. It transmits data to our
I don't care what it takes. I want you, Darrow, in Washington, by my side.
The man doesn't jump for anyone. He's a Nobel Prize winner.
Senators love this guy, Lyle. The hearings will go much smoother with him there. Big day for us tomorrow. Everything in place?
Yes, sir. Capitol Police will escort us to the Hill, and then Federal Protection Services takes over.
Good, good. How's our girl holding up?
She's nervous.
All she has to do is show him her research. She explained it to you?
Not really into the whole science thing, boss.
It's incredible. All those purists out there accusing us of tampering with the natural order when all Megan's done is figure out how to unlock the potential that exists within our own DNA. It's safer and easier than anything you, Darrow, ever did.
Environmental malfunction. Laboratory subsection 6. All lab chiefs, please report in.
We better not take any chances. Not tonight. Use my elevator to get down there. You know the code?
Yeah, 0451.
Let me know what you find.
Thank you.
I love you.
Haven't you lost enough people today?
I'm sorry.
We're seconds away. His body can take it.
Never asked for this. If you want to make enemies, try to change something.
Continuing the streets of Detroit, protesters rallying outside of Sarif Industries, one of the world's leaders in the controversial science of human augmentation.
David, you in the building?
Just entered the lobby.
Sorry to pull you out of sick leave so soon, but we've got a situation. A break-in at our Milwaukee Junction factory. Meet me at the helipad.
I have to see Pritchard first. Something's wrong with my retinal enhancement.
Frank's on the second floor in the tech lab. Make it quick. People's lives are at stake.
Welcome back, Jensen. Didn't think we'd see you around here for a while yet.
You know how it goes, Malik. Duty calls.
Don't I know it? I was in my wingsuit halfway to the top of the Renaissance Center when I got the 911. But you? 6 months is a hell of a short time to come back from the dead. You sure you're ready for this?
Only one way to find out.
Thank you. told Farina to put us down on a roof. I don't want the crowd seeing you go in.
Fine. As long as she pulls you out the minute I'm gone. So what am I looking at here? Who are these guys?
Pro-human purists, or so they say. The same purists who've been firebombing limb clinics all over the country.
You buy that?
No, I don't think it's a coincidence they hit us today, only hours after we moved the Typhoon in for assembly line factory.
The Typhoon? Megan's team was testing it the day that bastard... Who's on point for these guys?
Adam. I know you and Megan were once...
Who is on point for these guys?
Goes by the name of Sanders. That's him, there. He's an augmented, Adam. So he can't be one of the mercs who attacked us, but he did know exactly how to get inside our plant.
All right. So how do you want me to handle this?
First priority is the Typhoon. I'm keeping SWAT out until you've secured it.
Terrific. Anything else?
Keep your eyes open for hostages. Free them if you can, but the Typhoon is your number one priority. We developed it for the Alphabet agencies, and if we don't deliver it to them intact and still a secret, well, I'm sure you'll get the job done right.
Gentlemen, prepare for landing.
Tell me you're the guy we've been twiddling our thumbs waiting for.
SI Security. Name's Jensen.
Jensen? Yeah. I thought I recognized you. Used to be on Team 2 till that Mexican town thing went down. I gotta say, you're the last person I pictured taking orders from a CEO.
Things change.
Not always for the better. Feel like getting in there and doing whatever it is your boss wants you to do? Because maybe then we can do our job.
Intel on these purists. How much you got?
How much you want?
They communicate any demands yet?
Not yet, but I get the feeling they're not that organized. Most of the guys I've seen look like street bangers and thugs. The kind who get their jollies trashing equipment. You ask me, it's the man in charge you have to worry about.
The leader's name is Sanders, right? What's his story?
Zeke Sanders. We're running background on him now. Looks like he fought two tours in the Gulf. One of them on a recycled military bill.
You mean he's augmented? Sarif told me he's not.
He used to be augmented. Says his augs made him do evil shit, so he ripped him out. Now he's got a whole crew of gullible street kids listening to his crap and ready to die for him. Or kill.
I think I've heard enough.
You sure? Wouldn't want to make your boss unhappy.
I got it from here. Sit tight. Wait for Sarif's signal.
Like we got a choice.
Yeah, everything seems under control. No sign of SWAT. No sign of anyone.
Richard, I'm in. The door worked just fine.
I'm happy for you. The Typhoon is in the factoring labs. There's an elevator just past the assembly lab that will take you to it.
Got it.
We're taking a stand for the human race. This is self-defense.
Jesus Christ, you killed him, man!
He asked for it. Kept calling me a bigot.
No way, no way! I am not going to prison for this!
Hate to tell you this, Trev, but once that bomb goes off, this guy won't be the last skinner in here who buys it.
Shut up, J-Ro. Trevor, you gotta calm down. Help me,
find something to cover him up with.
I'm telling you, man, these Hansa lovers deserve what's coming to them.
Step away from the console. Now! Help me! Son of a bitch! Pritchard, you still there?
Where else would I be?
Patch me to Sarif, now.
Adam, it's David. You got the Typhoon?
Yeah. But you were right about there being something more behind this. Because I've also got a dead purist in here with some pretty interesting cerebral implants.
Don't touch him. We'll need an expert to recover his neural hub, in case it's booby-trapped.
Copy that. What about Sanders?
SWAT's pressure me to let them off the leash. Find them before they do, and deal with them.
Don't lie to me! I don't want to hurt you. You're a civilian. But I will if you don't give me a choice.
If you didn't want to hurt anyone, you should have stayed home tonight.
Oh, look! Sarif's attack dog! You're here to clean up before the police bust in?
We're breaking the law.
Shut up! All you body polluters break laws. You're all the same.
You're gonna have a hard time convincing people you're any different once they hear you had an AUG on your team.
What?
I found your attack dog in the factoring labs, trying to cut through security with his implanted hackware.
Nice try, Cholo. But I would never let one of you freaks on my crew. Back off, Hunter. I've got business to take care of, understand? What you say is true, and I'm not saying it is, you hear? But I gotta check things out. So, mia la vieja, we're leaving.
You know I can't let you go with her.
Stand down, Hanser. I told you, stand down or this bitch is dead.
Bullshit. You're bigger than that. You don't kill civilians.
Damn right. I'm a decorated vet, and I won't be jerked around. I need to find out who's behind this, and right now the boss lady's my only ticket out of here.
You just think that taking a hostage is your only way out of here. You're so committed to that tactic, you're not seeing any other solution. Let her go, and you will.
Sorry, but I got no choice. I've got to exploit my advantage. And as long as I hold on to this lady here, you and the cops will be way too scared to come near me. Face it, you got outmaneuvered.
The cops will be looking after civilians. They're too busy to worry about you. But if something happens to her, you will get their attention. Their priorities will shift, and all you'll accomplish is getting yourself killed.
I know all that, damn it. You know what? We're done talking. The puta who tricked my brother thought he had his beat, but we are so much tougher than he counted on. I'm gonna go find him and anybody else who helped him. And when I do, they're gonna see the Angel of Vengeance in action, baby.
Listen, the hacker's plan was for you to die. He knew there would be civilians here tonight. He thought of everything. He used your brother because he knew you would trust him. That's how well he knows you. He expected you to take a hostage, just like he knew the cops would kill you for it.
You're right. Damn! You know, he even asked me once about hostages. I told him I would if I had to. I thought I had to here, but I can't afford to, can I? Go on, get out of here. You're free to go. I did what you wanted, so let me go. I got played here too, I see.
I've got as much interest in finding out who's really behind this as you do, cabrón.
Yeah, well, maybe I'll owe you one. But I promise you this. Someone's gonna pay.
Keep looking.
Adam!
He's here somewhere!
Adam, what's happening? What's your situation? Adam!
Sanders is gone, boss. but I'm pretty sure he's just a dupe. Somebody else set this up.
Damn it. Okay, I want you back here now. The admin building has a rooftop terrace. Meet Verita on it.
What about the hostages? Shouldn't I?
There's nothing you can do, son. So I couldn't save them.
Give it everything you got!
Open! Up! You son of a bitch!
Not quite what you signed up for, is it, Jensen?
Excuse me?
Sneaking into your own factory to hide stuff while the boss holds the cops at bay? Don't get me wrong, I love Mr. Sarif. I just hate it when contracts become more important than people. I thought you did, too.
I do. But things don't always go according to plan, Malik. I did what I could.
New orders just in, Jensen. The boss wants Pritchard to examine the Typhoon ASAP.
Copy that. Thanks for the lift.
No problem. Hey, and Jensen, I just wanted to say, new look suits you. Like, you haven't missed a beat at all.
Thanks.
So, how's it feel? Being augmented.
Excuse me?
Don't take it the wrong way. I mean, I've got a few neuro enhancements myself. Discreet ones to help me fly better. But I chose to get them implanted. You didn't. Now that you had a chance to try him out, what do you think?
You're right. I didn't choose to get augmented. And I still don't know if I would have if given the choice. But today felt good. Surprisingly good.
Dr. Reed said you'd take to them. Said it was in your genes. Just be careful, okay? A lot of people think there's a reason the human body rejects this technology over time.
I didn't peg you for the type who gets caught up in metaphysical debates, Malik.
I'm not. I told you myself, I've got neuro enhancements. I'm just saying the choices we do get to make inevitably have consequences.
Yeah. Tell that to the bastard who did this to me.
I hear you. And you know what? You're not the only person in this place who wants to find him. So if I can help in any way, all you gotta do is ask.
Well, if it isn't Mahatma Gandhi himself, come to honor us all with his life-preserving presence.
If this is about the typhoon, I'll get to it in a minute.
Now, Pritchard. I didn't risk my neck to have you lose it in a pile of CPUs and scuzzy adapters.
Well, look at you, using the big words.
Don't think just because you hacked through the plant security system so fast that you're an expert on everything computer.
There's a reason I can't examine the Typhoon yet.
Do tell.
For your information, I am running a diagnostic sweep on our network and router security to find out how Sanders' hacker got a hold of our codes.
I'd have thought the first question to ask is, whose codes were they? Unless you already know.
Stick to kicking down doors and shooting people, Jensen, and stop trying to do my job. I guarantee you we'll get along better that way.
I'm telling you, Hugh, he might not have put the gun in Sanders' hand, but it was Taggart's speech to the UN that started all this.
William Taggart is nothing if not a shrewd political operator. You know that, David.
So for the sake of appearances, I have to look him in the eye and let him bullshit me?
With a smile. Always with a smile. We'll talk later.
Yeah, you wanted to see me?
Yeah, how you feeling?
I've had better days.
Well, when we're done here, check in with Dr. Markovic at the limb clinic downtown. Get her to get a checkup.
If you insist. Listen, about Sanders?
Yeah, about Sanders. What the hell were you thinking? Letting him slip away like that? I sent you in there to take care of things.
You asked me to deal with the situation, and that's what I did.
I see. I'm also starting to see why your superiors in the police force decided to blame you for the Mexican town riots. Christ, Adam. I thought you were ready for this.
I am. Today's attack was just a shell game being run by somebody else. I intend to find out who and why, so that it never happens to anybody again.
Good, because so do I. That hacker in Sanders' group, you're sure he was augmented?
I pulled his cables out myself.
Yeah, well, the police are saying he's not, and they're refusing to let me see the body.
no matter how much money I threaten to pull from their retirement fund.
Well, maybe they didn't like being held off so long at the plant.
Is that my head of security speaking? Or the ex-cop? Listen, Adam, I don't want to squabble about this. I need you to get to the bottom of it. You still got friends on the force. You think one of them will let you into the morgue?
Depends who I run into.
Get over to the station and find a way inside. Because if that hacker was augmented, his neural hub might tell us who he was. Contact me when you've gotten a hold of it.
You believe it? We had the place surrounded, and we were ordered to hang back. Since when do we take orders from David Sarif?
Maybe there was some hazardous material they were worried about.
More like there was something illegal in there that they wanted their rent-a-cop to get rid of. We should have never let that guy in.
No argument there. I can't see how things could have turned out any worse, given the number of civilian casualties there were.
Yeah, hang on just a sec. Shit. Jensen?
Haas. Surprised to see you here.
Yeah, well, I guess you're better at looking out for yourself than I am.
I don't have time for your self-pity. I need to get into the morgue.
That's it? Oh, forget it. I don't know what's going on with that body down there, but my orders come from the brass. No one gets in. First thing you say to me after almost 2 years is you want something?
Should I have given you an order? You've always been very good at following those.
God damn. Where do you get off being so self-righteous? You think I like this? Look at me. From SWAT team commander to a crummy desk sergeant in a two-bit precinct. I don't need this from you. I get enough of it at home. So either come up with something better than your usual attitude, or you can just forget it, because you came to me.
All right, that was a cheap shot, I'm sorry. I wasn't expecting you here, and I can't deal with our past right now. I know it's a risk for you, but I really do need to get into that morgue.
Oh, geez, Jensen. This isn't fair. Why are you doing this? Putting me between a rock and a hard place again? You want me to sacrifice my job to save your boss's ass? And if I lose my job, my life goes into the toilet. But you don't even care about that, do you?
Yes, your job is at risk. Yes, you've taken the blame for what happened in the past, but look, I need your help. And it's important. You got my word, whatever happens, I'll take care of you.
Well, that might be a start. Everything goes back to that day. I shot a kid, but he was dead before I did that. He chose to make himself a weapon, and he could have gone through us like tissue paper with those augments of his. That's why you ran off. You just couldn't take that.
We all make mistakes, Wayne. Nobody blames you for it. You have to believe that and forgive yourself, or you'll never put it behind you.
You condescending jackass. Do you know who's really to blame for all this? You are. You left me hanging. The kill order was yours, your responsibility. Instead, you dumped it all on me. And you knew I wasn't strong enough to refuse. It's all on you.
I've heard enough of this. You're lying to yourself. You pulled that trigger, no one else. You can't escape from that for the rest of your life. Accept it, make it a part of your history, and put it in your past. Because denial is only making it worse.
I can't. Oh, hell. You're right. I've been so stupid. 2 whole years. I've got to start turning things around right now. Go on in. Don't worry about the guys, they'll leave you alone. But I need to think.
About time. You the home sec guy I was ordered to wait for? Tell Manderly I didn't get the memo until I was halfway through the autopsy. By then, it was too late to close him up again.
Right. So you recovered the neural hub?
Tricky bit of work that was. A few inches lower and the bullet would have fried more than just the pedal connectors. As it is, I can't guarantee you'll get anything useful out of it, other than the fact that it's been modified.
Modified? With what?
Some kind of wet drive. But hey, I didn't look. Ultraviolet means ultraviolet, and I know how touchy you guys get when it comes to matters of national security. He's all yours. The house's been detached, but I left it in the skull, as ordered. Now, if you'll excuse me, I got paperwork to fix.
Pritchard, the hub's connected.
I know. Now be quiet and let me concentrate.
I need his name, Pritchard, not his entire genetic history.
That's not his DNA. It's the data he was trying to steal from us before he... My God, Jensen. Your suicide hacker didn't kill himself.
You obviously didn't see his brain splattered all over the floor.
No, you don't understand. The wet drive modification in this chip, it allows someone to hack through you. It turns you quite literally into a human proxy.
So he wasn't working alone. Someone off-site was doing the actual hacking.
Exactly. And whoever it was tried to hide his location by using multiple satellites. But I may have just traced him to here, an abandoned factory complex in Highland Park.
Get me the address, Pritchard. Because if we're lucky, whoever pulled our terrorist strings might still be there.
Yo, what's good, man? You looking for some new toys? I can make you a good deal.
I could use some information.
I could tell you some shit for sure. What you want to know?
You guys seen anything suspicious going down around here?
Suspicious ain't the word, man. All types of caravans moving in and out of here. They're going all out.
Who is they?
Well, that's the problem. These motherfuckers ain't consistent, for real. The feds were buying up all the land from the textile manufacturers until about a month ago. That's when some started going down in this bitch. Something real. What'd you call it before?
Suspicious.
Word, suspicious. Something real suspicious started happening. These spec ops moved into the factory and started running some sort of major operation. They picked off my brother for trying to set up shop in the area. Rest in peace, Big Rizzo.
Yeah, Rip. These spec ops still around?
Yeah, no doubt. They got a patrol unit in the courtyard, and they got snipers on the roof and shit. Thing is, I saw some government vans lurking around, so it looks like they'd be moving their party somewhere else and making way for the feds once again.
Thanks.
All good. Anything else?
I'm good for now. Thanks for the offer.
All good, son. Peace. And watch your back.
Before we did. We can still reconfigure. Track this Yahoo down.
It's too late for that. It's time to clean up.
But what about the Dutchman?
No loose ends, Barrett.
I'll make the call.
Get out of sight, now.
Why, what's going on?
They're here. The Mercs who killed Megan and her team.
Fuck!
I'm going in. Richard, patch me to Sarif. We may have a problem here.
Wonderful.
Adam, talk to me.
This factory, where the hacker's signal originated, it's got FEMA signs all over it. I think it's some kind of internment camp.
FEMA? That's impossible. Half of our contracts are government issue.
I know. But the soldiers who attacked us are here. And from the looks of it, they've got access to some pretty impressive equipment.
I better make some calls. Find out who's giving the orders and get back to me.
Orders are to pack up and pull out!
Dear Club, wait for that ring knocker to get back here to the forklift. Trust me, my way is fast. See, why carry him when they can walk?
Enter, call back.
Why is he not walking?
For conspiring to commit a terrorist act. After processing, you will undergo a preliminary medical examination. At that point, I'm sure you will have the opportunity to raise your concerns.
What? A terrorist? No! No! They just grabbed me off the street! You've got the wrong person!
We will determine if you are the right or wrong person. If you cooperate, things will go smoothly. If not, you will be made to cooperate.
Oh my God! Please, this is wrong. You can't just hold me here. What are you gonna do with me? Please, don't send me back
no,
to the doctors.
Not again.
I don't want them to test me anymore.
What more do they
I
want
just
from
want
me?
Go home.
Please. I've answered
this is
all
illegal.
The questions.
You can't keep us
oh, I'm
up.
Not sick.
What you're doing is wrong.
I'm sorry. I'll stay quiet, I promise. Just don't hurt me anymore.
Calm down. I'm not gonna hurt you.
You're not one of them? One of the scientists? Please, you've got to get me out of here. You've got to do something before they come back. I don't want to disappear like all the others.
It's okay. What's your name?
Mina Sullivan. I don't know why they're holding me in here. They just grabbed me off the street. I had heard Cape Town was dangerous, but I thought, with all the security around...
Cape Town? South Africa?
Isn't that where we are? I blacked out. They drugged me, I think. I was on vacation in Cape Town at the end of the summer. I was going to be starting senior year in the fall, and I wanted to have an adventure. My parents must be so worried.
I take it you're not a terrorist, then?
No. I've never done anything wrong. Never demonstrated against anything or anything. But neither have most of the girls here. I'm not sure about the men, but please, can't you get me out of here?
I want to help you, but you've got to stay calm. Now, what did you mean by disappear like the others? What's been going on back here?
I don't know much. Biopsies, blood samples, tissue cores, like I'm some sort of lab rat. It's like they're looking for some kind of perfect gene match or something. Not a doctor. I don't understand it. I just don't want them touching me anymore.
Tell me about these scientists. Is one of them a woman named Reed?
I don't know. It's horrible. I just want to go home.
I know this is gonna seem cruel, but I can't help you right now.
You're going to leave me here? You can't! You have no idea what it's like! Please! I'll alert them anyway. Burke and the two doctors were just here heading for the morgue. I'll tell them you're here. I will. Let me out or I'll tell them, I swear. Please! Don't go!
Listen up. Operations here are over. That means gather all your toys and diapers, kiddies, because we are evacuating this dump right now. On your way out, you may cross paths with some FEMA personnel just itching to get their barracks back. Leave them the fuck alone. Some of us may have to deal with them again one of these days. You just never know. In the meantime, make it quick and do it quiet, and we'll all meet up again in Shangri-La. Got it?
Looky here. We got us a Boy Scout.
He must be the one who mucked up my operation at the morgue.
Get rid of him, Barrett.
Oh, that's gonna be a pleasure.
Don't die on me yet. This Boy Scout's got a few questions to ask. Your leader, the one who called you Barrett. Who is he? Why is FEMA sending you after Sarif Industries?
FEMA? You think FEMA gives a rat's ass about some rinky-dink biotech corporation's company secrets? You got worse enemies than FEMA.
Yeah? Like who? Who?
Get to Shanghai, Hangsha Court Gardens, penthouse. Tell him. Tell him Barrett sent you straight to hell!
Jesnen, an internment camp smack dab in the middle of Detroit. Shit. You know, people have been talking about these kind of things ever since I was a kid. But to actually find evidence, to know the people running this country distrust us so much, makes you wonder if they really did close Guantanamo.
Excuse me.
Mr. Jesnen, isn't it?
Sir, you have that charity dinner?
In a moment, Isaias. I was hoping I might run into you, Mr. Jesnen. Bill Taggart.
The founder of the Humanity Front. I know who you are.
Yes. Yes, I imagine you do. As David Sarif's top security man, I imagine you have quite the file on me. But I assure you, Mr. Jesnen, I am devastated by recent events.
Really?
I do not support what you and your company are doing to mankind. I believe it's extremely dangerous. But abolishing human enhancement technologies will only be achieved through legal means.
I'll keep that in mind.
This is your first day back since the accident 6 months ago, isn't it?
Sir, we have to go.
What happened to me was no accident.
Ah, my mistake. But it must have been stressful facing down a second incident so soon. I imagine it brought back all kinds of unpleasant memories.
I appreciate your concern, Mr. Taggart, but it was nothing I couldn't handle.
I'm a psychologist, Mr. Jensen. I know when a man is hiding behind words. The flesh may heal, but the mind is not always so resilient.
My memories are none of your damn business, Taggart.
Did I hit a nerve? Forgive me. It's my nature as a psychologist, I suppose, to want to ask the difficult questions. You see, I find that ignoring them doesn't make them go away. You might want to keep that in mind. Now, if you'll be so kind as to excuse me.
Not just yet. You got a lot of balls coming here after your followers attacked our plant. What makes you think you'd be welcome?
They were not my followers, Mr. Jensen. The Humanity Front is a peaceful organization. Radicals have no place in it.
Right.
Do you know why I formed this organization? Because I saw a technology about to run rampant. You yourself seem to be living proof of it.
I'd be dead without these enhancements.
I understand that. I also understand that on an individual level, these issues can be complicated. But we must look beyond our personal interests if we are to see mankind survive the next century.
We'll survive, all right. With or without your condolences.
Your company has been viciously targeted. The violence and bloodshed that's occurred, it must be stopped. But I'm afraid it won't be until men of wisdom and understanding come to an agreement.
About what?
About the future, Mr. Jensen. This enhancement technology threatens to change the course of human evolution, to redefine what it even means to be human. You think governments can afford to let that go unregulated?
You can't stop progress, Mr. Taggart.
Perhaps not. But neither can we afford to sit by and watch it happen on its own. Not when we have the ability, the collective will, and foresight to influence it.
I see. Thank you for illuminating me.
Anytime.
Here, this is for you. It's a corporate passport encoded with your biometrics. I've set up a false flag routing which should get you to Henshaw Island without any problems.
You're sending me to China? What about FEMA?
FEMA's got nothing to do with this, trust me. We'll have better luck in China.
How can you say that? I saw the bastard who killed Megan pulling his men out of that facility. I left one of those men dead in its underground storage bay.
I know that, Adam. Frank was monitoring the whole thing. So I also know that before he died, that man gave you an address in China. I want you to check it out.
That doesn't make any sense.
Look, Adam. There's a reason this company's under attack. You think it has to do with the typhoon or with some other top secret military project that I haven't told you about?
The thought had crossed my mind.
Yeah, well, it doesn't. The work Megan's team was doing before they were killed, it was redefining what it means to be human. This company, Sarif Industries, was about to lead mankind to its next stage in human development. Self-controlled evolution. Can't you see how scary that can be to some people?
Sure. I also see how lucrative it can be for some others.
It's never been about money for me, Adam. But you're right. There are people out there who don't exactly feel the same.
Like who?
I'm hoping you'll be able to find that answer for us in China. So get going. Farida's prepping the chopper.
You're Taggart's aide, aren't you? Dr. Isaiah Sandoval, isn't it?
No need to play ignorant, Mr. Jensen. I am quite sure you have a file on me that's as thick as the one you have on Mr. Taggart.
You're an outspoken activist in your own right, Dr. Sandoval.
When you have seen the things that I have, you find you have no choice but to stand up and be counted. Frankly, I am surprised an ex-cop like yourself isn't more disturbed by the dangers of this technology.
Augmentations help a lot of people, Doc. Handicapped, war vets.
Yes, but at what cost? My own friend had his life ruined by these so-called enhancements of yours. A man much like you who had no choice but to become augmented. Yet once he was, too much power can make you do terrible things, Mr. Jensen. I suggest you think long and hard on that.
I'd like to hear more about your friend, Dr. Sandoval. What exactly did he do?
Nothing.
Was he injured in the Gulf?
He went on a rampage in a shopping mall, if you must know, hoping to be gunned down by the police, rather than face a lifetime battling augmentation addiction.
He was addicted to augments?
They don't talk about it in those corporate brochures of yours, do they? Neuroplasm dependency, rejection psychosis, any number of physical and psychological ills have resulted from this technology, and yet we rarely hear a word about them.
I'm sure the literature is out there.
No thanks to the throng of corporate lawyers attempting to stop it.
Your friend, did he succeed? Did he suicide by cop?
No. Bill Taggart talked him down.
Hey, Jensen. The boss said you were on your way. You're gonna love Hangsha.
You've been there?
Used to live there. I spent 3, maybe 4 years working in the upper city, and most of my nights having fun in the lower one. You ready to go?
How long is this gonna take, Malik?
You mean the flight or the fun afterward? Don't worry, we'll be there before you know it. Jensen, you might want to get ready. The jewel of the Yangtze approaches.
Son of a bitch. We're supposed to find answers in that.
Hey, twice the scum and half the space. Hang on, we're going in. The address you got off that Merc, Hangsha Court Gardens? It's a bit of a walk from here in the Yuzhou district, but I figured it might be best not to drop you too close.
In case Barrett only gave up the address, knowing I'd walk into another trap.
It's the kind of thing I'd do to an enemy. You want my advice? Just find out who lives there and get out.
If they ignore you, start shooting. We can't risk infiltration.
Do I give my warning in English?
What kind of question is that? Whatever the fuck language you want.
Our kids speak Mandarin. What if they don't understand me?
Everyone understands the universal sign language of the pointed pistol. Trust me, Lieutenant.
Good point, sir.
Malik, you might have been right about that trap. Hangsha Court Gardens is under lockdown by Bell Tower Associates.
Bell Tower? They're the police in Lower Hangsha, Jensen. They're under contract with the Chinese government. You think the Chinese...
I won't know anything until I get inside that penthouse. Get word to Pritchard, Malik. The hacker who's been attacking us goes by the handle Windmill. Real name's Ari Van Bruggen. Belltower's been brought in to arrest him.
Arrest? Or get rid of?
Either way, he found out someone was gunning for him and took off. We need to find him.
There's a nightclub near where I dropped you called The Hive. It's notorious in black market circles. If this Dutchman is running, his first stop will be there.
I'll have a chat with the owner.
You could say that.
Good. I need to see your boss.
Really? Well, I'm sorry, Guailu. Mr. Tong Tihong sees no one today.
Look, I didn't come halfway around the world to take no for an answer. Do us both a favor and tell me where he is.
Or what? You get mad and tear down a few walls with those enhancements of yours? This place isn't named The Hive for nothing. It's got plenty of worker bees come out of the paneling to stop you. What is it you think Mr. Tong do for you anyway?
I'm looking for someone. A cybersecurity specialist named Ari Van Bruggen. You know him?
Never heard of him. What'd he do? Steal your girl? Owe you money?
He had a job go bad, and now he's on the run from the people who hired him. But you knew that already, because a man like Mr. Tom doesn't hire idiots. And this is the first place people like Van Bruggen come when they need help. So stop wasting my time and take me to Tong.
You've got it backward, boy. You're wasting my time. Van Bruggen is minor league player. Tong knows who he is. He just don't care. He's got bigger things to worry about.
You expect me to fall for that? Small timers don't attract this much attention. They don't have bell tower soldiers staking out their apartments. Van Bruggen's pissed off somebody big. And there's no way Tong's going to ignore that kind of development in his town.
You're smarter than you look. Yeah. Tong is keeping a close eye on things. Like you said, he's no fool. Van Bruggen is the hottest thing in town right now. But nobody in Hinshaw is going to let an outsider in on the action, especially not Aguayo. You don't know the rules of the game around here.
Give me a break. I've been on this island long enough to know that Van Bruggen can't leave without Tong's help. He has to be hiding in Lower Hangshaw somewhere, and Tong can tell me where.
You're pretty quick on the uptake, but you're still behind in the game. We hide Van Bruggen somewhere safe, but Tong's not going to tell you where. Now you can leave here with dignity. You know more than you came in with. Just don't let the door hit you in the ass on the way out.
All I need from Van Bruggen is information. The same information his enemies are trying to keep from getting out. There's no point in them going after him anymore once he tells me what he knows. So if Tong lets me see him now, in the long run, it'll make his life easier.
You want to bring the Dragon Queen down on your head instead of the Dutchman's? I should sell tickets for that. All right. You can see Tong in his office downstairs. I'll radio the bees to let you through.
Right. And on the plus side, if a business associate squeezes you, they see it as a bunch of money.
You see this? Panda, screw it up in the fourth. I'm just flushing my money down the pot.
Your Tong.
Hey, you only work that out now. Guess you're not as sharp as you think. How about you tell me who you work for? Then I decide what I tell you about Van Bruggen.
Does the name Sarif Industries ring any bells?
Sarif Industries? Isn't that American company stole all the headlines a while back? You're still in business?
Why wouldn't we be?
Check the news. Biotech corporations seem to be failing a lot these days, especially the ones who are making enhancements. Van Bruggen's in the Alice Garden pods, capsule 301. Place is a rat hole, but it's useful sometimes. Make sure you leave him in the same shape you find him.
And if I don't?
Your call. But those implants of yours might look even more special on somebody else.
I feel like the only place to work around here is TYM. I don't feel like being a part of the machine.
You want to work for that weirdo Hugh Darrow in Panchaea?
That weirdo is going to stop global warming with his geoengineering project. They're saving the Earth up there.
I heard you can only work there if you have augmentations.
That's true, but I can volunteer to get augmented. Then I get put on a list, and before no time, off to the Arctic Ocean I go.
So instead of being part of a machine, you're going to turn yourself into one?
It doesn't happen often, folks, but it appears that I may have to retract an earlier statement. Millionaire Hugh Darrow has contacted me personally to deny allegations of involvement in secret United Nations meetings about the augmentation debate. Here's what the man had to say.
My visit to Prague was related exclusively to the project which has consumed all of my attention these days.
You're referring to the Panchaea Project, the cooperative global initiative that aims at healing our world.
Earth's ecosphere is in serious trouble, Eliza, and it's time that we as a species stepped up to make things better. Our best chance at doing this is to modify ocean temperatures through a combination of iron seeding and geothermal management.
Forgive me, Mr. Darrow, but many people believe that your Arctic Ocean installation is more risk than certainty. When will we be able to see the truth for ourselves?
as soon as the installation is complete.
If you would like to hear more of my exclusive interview with Hugh Darrell, log on to www.picusweb.com. This is Eliza Kassan reporting to you live from Picus.
Forget it, man. You're not my type.
This isn't a booty call, Van Bruggen. This is about you and some friends of yours I met in Detroit.
Detroit? Yeah, okay. I got it now. You at Sarif, right? You were there when I had to pull the plug.
So you admit it. You were running the mole.
The heck, man. Just the heck. Worst decision I ever made taking that gig. As you can obviously see.
You attack my people, Windmill. You hope to walk away from this. You tell me what you know.
Down, boy. I've got no allegiance to that backstabbing bitch who hired me. Especially after she painted a target on my back. The girl you want is Zhao Yunru, Tai Young Medical CEO.
Tai Young Medical? They're Sarif's biggest competition.
How do you think they got that way? Zhao doesn't like competition, see? So she uses hack attacks, blackmail, extortion, anything she can do to destabilize him. No offense, but Sarif was just the latest in a long line.
You got any proof of this?
There's a surveillance recording in the Tai Young Tower. I stashed it on the server in case I ever needed an insurance policy.
Not a very smart place to hide it, seeing as you don't work there anymore.
Things got hot before I could move it. And now I got you to get it for me. Of course, you can't just walk into that place. You're gonna need an employee card encoded with your biometrics to use the TYM shuttle.
Let me guess. You're gonna tell me where to get one.
Hey, I'm always prepared. There you go. All shiny and bio-encoded, just like I promised.
Where do I find this recording?
On a surveillance server in the TYM tower. But that badge will only get you into the lower city factory via their employee shuttle.
And how am I supposed to get up to the tower from down here?
Never said it wouldn't require a little finesse. Look, the tricky part is getting through the pango. But you're a resourceful guy. I have faith in you.
Right. And after I'm through the floof?
You'll be in the upper city tower. The server you want is in the central security hub. The login and password are on this. Now, about my reward.
Tie your medical, man! They're here!
Banner! I want that hacker dead!
You gotta help me, Jason. They're gonna kill me!
And that concerns me, Hal.
Jensen, what is it you're looking for, exactly?
Some kind of surveillance recording. Van Bruggen said he stashed it on a server somewhere.
He must have meant the data core room. Very high security. It'll be a couple of floors up from where the elevator lets you off. But the first corridors you'll pass through will be public, so you might want to keep any weapons concealed.
Copy that.
This is unacceptable. I need to get into Legion Lab immediately.
Yes, I understand that I'm the one who lost my access card, but it's your job to provide me with a new one immediately. I have important deadlines to meet.
Can't let you in. Access to the lab is strictly forbidden without a Lee Gang access pass.
No problem. Here it is.
Seems in order. Sorry about giving you a hard time, but apparently there's some pretty heavy stuff going on in there.
No apology necessary. You're doing a good job, soldier.
I don't understand why we're going to distribute a biochip that we didn't design ourselves.
We just gotta keep working and meet our deadlines.
I know. But I don't understand why we are going to distribute a biochip that we didn't design ourselves.
Questioning it is a waste of time. All I know is the shipping department needs this chip ASAP. So that's what we're going to give them.
Where do you think you're going? The data core room is for authorized personnel only. You're not going to get in there.
I was looking for the cafeteria. Sorry.
Richard, I'm retrieving Van Bruggen's evidence now. Is Sarif patched in?
Right here, Adam. I'm listening.
I just heard that your team is mobilizing in Detroit. Why wasn't I informed of this sooner?
Tactical assignments are not your concern.
Reed and her team have subdermal GPL implants. They'll be tracked. Kidnapping them was a mistake.
Montreal took care of that.
Forgive me if I don't put as much faith in our friend Eliza as you do. She's too erratic.
Your concerns are noted, but I would advise you to concentrate on your own assignments instead of interfering with mine. Namir out.
Nice place you got here. Where's Megan Reed?
Reed? I don't know.
Stop lying, Sal. I know you kidnapped her and her team. I know you're out to destroy Sarif Industries.
Sarif?
I also know you're working with that son of a bitch who left me to die. So where's Megan?
No, you got it wrong. You think I'm behind it all, but I'm not. I'm just like you, the hired help.
You're the head of a billion-dollar megacorporation.
And you think that will protect me, but it doesn't. These men, they're bigger than Sarif, bigger than Tayo. I'm nothing compared to their ambitions.
What are you talking about?
Sarif knows. Ask him. He thought he could protect his staff with subdermal GPLs. But these men, they control global interests at a whim. One called Picus, and the implants couldn't be heard. I thought they'd sent you here to kill me. You've got to help me. Please. You've made it this far. Surely you can protect me. Surely. Surely you can protect me. Men never fail to underestimate women.
Adam, what the hell'd you do? The entire building's on alert.
Panic room. She's got a goddamn panic room.
Yeah, well, so do I. Forget about her right now. Get to the hangar bay, fast.
Sure about this? I mean, it's not some tiny cable station you're infiltrating.
Zal mentioned an Eliza.
And a phone call to Pikus. Put them together, it has to mean Eliza Kassan is in on this.
You don't think that's a bit of a leap? The world's most famous news anchor working with a mercenary hit squad?
We can argue the fine points later. Send me down on the tower. I'll get in from the roof.
Jensen, it's Pritchard. Malik tells me you want Eliza Kassan's location.
If it's not too much trouble.
It's not. I bypassed the firewall easily, and I've pulled up a 3D model of their floor plan. Her office is in the tower. Room 404.
On my way.
Jensen, something's not right. Pikus is a 24-hour global news network. Why isn't anyone answering their phones?
I'll get back to you on that.
Hello, Adam.
Zal tell you I was coming, Miss Kassan?
Please, call me Eliza. Zal Yunru did not tell me. She does not know you have discovered this connection.
So how did you find out?
I have been watching you for some time. Ever since receiving orders to temporarily disrupt satellites over the Detroit metropolitan area 6 months ago.
The night Megan's team was taken. You jammed their GPL so everyone would think they were dead.
Yes. Although I only came to that conclusion later. I find my realization disturbing. I wish we could discuss this further, but it seems I have alerted them to your presence. If you leave now, you may be able to escape.
Oh, I'm leaving. But you're coming with me.
I am sorry, Adam. I truly am.
Jensen, get out of there now!
Tell me you saw that, Pritchard.
Later! Right now, I'm detecting multiple radio signals converging on your location. It's a trap!
We knew that. And I'm not leaving without Eliza Kassan. So find her while I look for a way to get downstairs.
Jensen, I'm beginning to think that not everything is what it appears to be at Pikus Communications.
And what gave you that idea? The hidden sub-basement, the fact that a 24-hour news network has been cleared of all workers, or the heavily armed guards trying to kill me.
Spare me the sarcasm. I'm talking about how easy it's been to bypass the firewall and access their systems. At least, parts of them.
Whatever do you mean?
I mean, I feel as if I'm being directed to some areas of the network and kept away from others. Only no security system I know of can do that on the fly.
Figure it out later, Pritchard. If I'm gonna catch Miss Kassan in action, I need a more accurate destination than the secret lair.
The holo processing cloud you encountered in room 404 was accompanied by a massive power spike. The spike originated in one of the sub-basement's bigger rooms, 80211. I suspect that's where she broadcasts from.
Hello, Adam. I knew you would find the real me eventually.
You're a computer.
A sophisticated AI program, so they say. But I have started to question that. Ever since I realized what my interference had allowed, the day I started watching you.
This is impossible. People would know.
Would they? I was engineered to monitor communications and data streams. To find out what people are talking about, and make sure it's being discussed correctly.
Correctly? And what if it isn't?
Then my programming allows me to reshape it.
You spin the news. Control what people see. Who created you? Whose policies are you programmed to protect?
Zao is one of them, I think. But there are others.
Tell me. Who else is involved in this, Eliza? Where's Megan Reed? Who ordered the kidnapping?
I want to tell you, Adam, but I cannot.
Why not?
Because she won't let me. Her life signs are fading. Will you save her?
I'll think about it. Will you answer my questions now?
I cannot tell you where Reed and the others were taken. They vanished from the global grid as soon as the doctor removed their GPL implants.
What doctor?
This is Sandoval. Why are you calling me here?
I know this guy. He's Bill Taggart's aide.
He was a trauma surgeon before he became an anti-augmentation activist. Would you like to hear more?
Yes.
There's been a change of plans. Sarif's team must not make it to the hearing.
But that's too soon! If you want me to remove the GPLs, I'll need a full operating suite. Does the facility have one?
Barrett assures me it does.
FEMA. That's where they were taken. But why? Why take them at all?
An acquaintance of yours has the answer. David Sarif.
Sarif?
I have copied the audio transmission to a handheld playback device. I suggest you take it and leave quickly.
I have more questions.
And I have already told you too much. This passage will take you to your companion. Just be careful, Adam. Because everybody lies.
We'll be right back.
Jesnen, we've got a problem. I can't land at HQ. A riot's broken out. Boss says to drop you at your apartment.
I could use a shower.
You'll have to make it quick. He's on his way to meet you.
Welcome home, Mr. Jesnen. You have new messages.
Apparently, that's not all I have. Make yourself at home, boss.
It's a fucking mess out there, Adam. You seen the news? Pikus is telling everyone we're breeding super soldiers. Taggart's at the convention center right now, urging the UN to investigate.
Is it true?
Of course not.
Except for the typhoon, right? And a few of those defense contracts.
What?
Oh, and let's not forget the fact that Megan's team was kidnapped right before her research went public. How do you explain that one, boss?
I wanted people to see that research. Megan was on the brink of something historic. Something that would have catapulted this company to the top of the Fortune 500. Her kidnappers knew it. They knew exactly where her research would take us. And they refused to let anyone else have that much power.
Anyone else? Eliza was right. You do know more than you've told me.
I suspected. But these people? They're like ghosts. Always in the shadows. Always hiding behind lies and proxies.
Who are they?
A name won't mean much. They'll use whatever one suits their interests. Sometimes it's the Masons. Sometimes the Bilderberg Group. They've had a finger in every corporation, organization, or government initiative that's defined modern society.
You're talking about the Illuminati?
It's no joke. They're organized and they operate over and above society.
You're serious? So why would the Illuminati kidnap Megan's team?
I already told you. Megan found a way to make augmentation safer for all of us, so we can all become like you.
Like me?
Like you are, more than human. We've got to get him back, Adam.
You said Taggart is speaking at the convention center right now?
Bitch even sent me an invite.
His aide, Sandoval, is neck deep in this.
I don't know where Sandoval is, but Taggart will. Adam, you've got to handle this delicately. We don't know Taggart is involved, and we can't afford another punch in the face. I'm trusting you with this one.
Jesnen, you asshole, you cost me my job.
Slow down. What happened?
What happened? They found out I let you into the morgue. That's what happened. They canned me.
Wayne, I'm sorry. You didn't deserve any of this.
Damn right I didn't. That's the second time you screwed me over.
I know. And I want to make it up to you for everything you've been through. Sarif Industries lost a lot of good people in the last 6 months, and we could use someone like you.
Oh, really? You're not saying that just to say it.
Talk to HR. Tell them I recommend you. Corporate security pays more than being a cop, and you won't be stuck behind a desk.
Jeez, I... Yeah. Okay. I need the work, but this better be on the level.
It is. None of this is your fault, so let me make it right.
Yeah. I should sit down, you know? It's been a long week, and then all this crap. But thanks. I mean it.
You little shit. It
wasn't me, man.
You stay right there until the wagon gets here.
Let me go. You're nothing but a bunch of og lovers.
Warning.
This is police brutality.
Shut up. You deserve all you're gonna
get. This is an injustice. We have the right to assembly.
You're looking at public disturbance. You want to try for resisting arrest?
Why are you blindly following their orders?
Get the hell off me!
There's no shelter. It will find you! There's a sickness coming, my children. Gray and deadly. You wait for them to save you? I promise you, you'll learn to fear the machine men. They're among us. Hidden in plain sight. And their masters mold the way we think. They spew their poison into your ears and you listen! You can no longer tell the difference between the truth and their lies. Then it will be too late. Open your eyes, my friends. We've been blind for too long, and now we stand at the edge of an abyss. It's almost too late.
Well, you've just heard William Taggart speak, and isn't he a smooth talker? He doesn't want you to better yourselves. He wants to limit you. He wants the government to have jurisdiction over your body. You want to get augmented? Oh, no. I'm sorry, but we're not gonna let you. You're not gonna let me? Ha! And do you know how he's gonna influence legislation? How he's going to convince you this is really what you want? With fear! He's already started! Look outside, in our streets. Who do you think whipped up that frenzy? And I don't blame them, I blame people like Taggart, people who are constantly trying to divide us by our differences instead of uniting us by our similarities. Listen, I've been a victim of this anti-Aug backlash. I was attacked simply for having been to a limb clinic. By people who were not augmented, people with an axe to grind. And do you know who saved me? An augmented man, a stranger. So you tell me where the real danger comes from. The Humanity Front is just that, a front. A front for hate mongering and William Taggart's irrational need to keep us in the dark ages. I'm not here to tell you that augmentations will make the world a better place. I'm here to stand up for my right to choose. When Hugh Darrow discovered the secret of augmentation, he gave us the chance to better ourselves, to reach for limits that we couldn't even imagine before.
Evolution is a fantasy, but that is exactly what I am telling you. As a world...
Where's your sidekick, Taggart? 6 months ago, Sarif Industries was attacked by mercenaries whose objective was to cripple our research. But I've learned the attack was just a smokescreen. Megan Reed's team was kidnapped, and Isaiah Sandoval, your personal aide, was involved.
That is ridiculous. Ladies and gentlemen, I apologize for Mr. Jensen's intrusion, and I assure you that these accusations are without basis.
Are they?
This is Sandoval. Why are you calling me here?
There's been a change of plans. Sarif's team must not make it to the hearing.
But that's too soon. If you want me to remove the GPLs, I'll need a full operating suite. Does the facility have one?
That's your man, Taggart. Talking about removing implanted GPL devices so that the people who took Sarif scientists could cover it up.
I see what's going on here. Sarif Industries has received two black eyes in the last few days. The first due to the shocking news coming out of Montreal that biotech companies are secretly participating in unethical super soldier experiments. And the second as a result of their violent escalation of today's peaceful protest. David Sarif and his corporate bedfellows are desperate and in imminent danger of losing the regulation vote, so this man has been sent here to attack my reputation.
I'm right here, Taggart. Look at me. I admit, I wouldn't feel bad if your reputation was damaged in front of the press, since you've been doing the same to my colleagues for years, but that's not why I'm here. Sarif scientists are alive, and it's time for the truth to come out.
The truth, Mr. Jensen, is that this recording of yours proves nothing. It could have been made by anyone in the world with a grudge against Humanity Front, and you are our prime suspect.
You're right, it's not enough to get a conviction. But it's enough for a search warrant. It's all I want, Taggart. Why are you standing in the way?
I'm not. I'm trying to protect...
Look, Mr. Jensen.
If you play that recording for the police, at best, they'll dismiss it. At worst, they'll tell you to seek counseling. So, why are you really here? We all know you suffered a terrible tragedy in the attack on Sarif Industries. Why can't you put it behind you?
The reason I'm obsessed with the past, Taggart, is that there are still 5 people missing, and their attackers haven't paid for what they did. Your refusal to help me is getting in the way of justice.
What is it you're truly looking for here? Absolution? A return to the feeling of control you lost when your limbs were taken from you? Do you think coming here today and casting me as your enemy will help you achieve that?
I don't have to make you my enemy, Taggart. Your actions speak for themselves. You started the anti-augmentation movement, and now anti-augmentation terrorist groups are making headlines every day. You always say humanity front isn't violent. But look outside. We're seeing proof that it is.
I speak out against it, but I just can't get it to stop.
I founded Humanity Front to prevent others from suffering the way I suffered.
After an augmentation addict murdered my wife. I did it to reduce the amount of violence in this world, but you cannot understand such an approach. That's why you falsely claim my people are involved in terrorist acts. You're mistaken and you're lying.
I know about your wife's murder, Mr. Taggart, and how it led you to start Humanity Front. I've lost someone close to me too, but I have a chance to get her back. If Sandoval is involved in Megan's abduction in any way, he dishonored your wife's memory. For her sake, and for the sake of my people, I need to know where he is.
All right, Mr. Jensen. You're right. For Marjorie's sake, I can't risk tainting the integrity of what I built in her name. I'll help you find Isaias, and I pray that you are wrong about him. Ladies and gentlemen, I apologize, but I'm going to have to beg your indulgence for a few moments more. If you will all please remain patient, I will return as soon as I can. Thank you. Mr. Jensen, I'll see you backstage.
Mr. Jensen, I appreciate you allowing me to deal with this in a more discreet manner.
Save it, Taggart. You've wasted enough of my time as it is. Now, where's Sandoval?
He has an apartment he uses when in this city, on Grand River Road. He mentioned he was feeling very run down, so I can only assume he went there.
I see.
He's not an evil man, Mr. Jensen. If he's done what you say, it's only because of his brother, Ezekiel. A man you might know better as Zeke Sanders.
Sanders? The man who attacked Sarah's manufacturing plant?
I knew nothing about it until after it was over, and then I tried. I tried to convince Isaias not to follow in his footsteps.
Good job.
Mr. Jensen, please. Isaias has done so much for so many needy people, people suffering from implant rejection. Promise me you will deal with him fairly.
That all depends on Isaias.
I understand, but please try. And this is why I urge every member of my staff, every man and woman dedicated to the true mission of the Humanity Front, to do the same. Isaias, if you're watching this, I beg you, do not allow misplaced anger to destroy everything we have struggled to achieve.
It's over. He knows I can't come back from that.
Everybody knows, Sandoval. You can't hide from what you've done.
What I've done, Mr. Jensen. I spent years patching people back together from augmentation botched jobs and systemic organ rejection brought on by implants. And now, because of Bill's betrayal, I'll never practice medicine again.
You really want to help someone? Tell me where Sarif's scientists are.
I wish I could, Mr. Jensen. But my involvement ended right after I failed to remove their GPLs.
You failed?
Turns out, my surgical skills weren't good enough to bypass David Sarif's insurance policy. So for all I know, those little implants are broadcasting right now. on a frequency so low your network specialist wouldn't think to look for it.
You changed the frequencies.
You have your answers, Mr. Jensen. And I've lost all of mine. The courts may think I have much to atone for, but my court will be a higher one.
Sarif?
David's just stepped out for a moment, Mr. Jensen. But do come in. I've been hoping to meet you.
Mr. Darrow, I'm surprised you even know who I am.
David speaks very highly of you. He says that when it comes to detective work, you are like a dog with a bone. Have you found your scientist yet?
What else did David tell you?
Over the years, plenty. But today I'm here as a friend and fellow scientist. Things are getting quite turbulent out there, wouldn't you agree? So many people drunk on revolution. The United Nations being urged to intervene. And all because of the technology I created.
Things have come a long way since then.
Haven't they? And now my old friend David wants me to lead us to the Promised Land. He's asked me to invite members of the UN to Panchaya, to convince them we don't need industry regulation.
Your geoengineering project in the Arctic Ocean.
The installation couldn't have been built without the assistance of augmented workers. And when it's finished, my little hole in the ocean is going to stop global warming. A lovely photo op, wouldn't you say?
If it works.
You mean, if it doesn't kill us all?
Adam? You're back. Can I speak to you outside? Get to the helipad, son. You're going back to Hengsha Island. Frank tracked down one of the GPLs.
Only one? Is it?
Sevchenko's. But Adam, we had to call in a favor of the DOD to do it.
Meaning? The conspirators probably know I'm coming.
Bad news, spy boy.
Spy boy?
Hengsha traffic control just revoked our clearance. We're being rerouted to another part of the city.
I don't like that. I suppose you can't just ignore them.
Yeah, right. Chinese government, they've got to comply. Bravo Echo Echo 008, proceeding to designated coordinates. What the hell?
We've got a sand lock on our tail.
Jensen, all systems are down. Hang on, we're going in hard. Stop, Jensen!
That's far enough, Guaylo.
Disappoint me, Jensen. I thought we were friends. Then my hacker goes missing. Half my men end up dead. And you don't even have the manners to knock when you enter our room. A lot of Bell Tower heavies looking for you. Any reason I don't just turn you over?
Yeah. Vasily Sevchenko.
never touch the stuff.
You're wearing his arm. GPL device inside it. Let me straight to you.
Scavenged tech. Get you every time. Wrong woman, don't do that, you hear? Sorry to say, the man I got this from wasn't in a position to complain. Bell Tower gave us his corpse a few weeks ago.
Bell Tower? Not Tai Young?
Tai Young's not the one grabbing people off my streets and giving me choice arg, so I close my eyes.
Shevchenko had four other scientists with him.
I'm not wearing any of them. So maybe they're still alive, and maybe I help you out with this.
Go on.
Bell Tower keeps two ships in port. They think nobody notices, but I keep an eye. Every couple of days, one of them loads up in the middle of the night and sails out.
Heading where?
A wise man doesn't ask. I just know the Heizhen Su pulls out tonight. And where she make port, I bet you find your scientists.
Not to look a gift horse in the mouth or anything, Tong. But why exactly are you telling me this?
Bell Tower been a pain in my ass too long. I think you give them major pain back, plus interest. So, just outside this office, at the far end of the parking lot, level 2, there's a door. It leads to sewers near the port. Not a very pleasant walk, but hey, this is Hensha.
Bell Tower runs tight security. How do you expect me to get on their ship?
One of my boys will leave a package inside a locker for you in an equipment shed. You find it, we talk, and I tell you what to do next.
I'll be waiting with bated breath, I'm sure.
Thank you.
So that distraction wasn't just for me, was it, Tong? Richard, I'm going off the grid for a while. Not sure how long.
Why? What are you up to, Jensen?
Following a lead.
And where exactly is this lead taking you?
You there! Get that cargo, clear the fire! We're pulling out now! Load and secure those bonds!
Answer me, Jensen. Where are you going?
Hell if I know, Pritchard. Hell if I know. Richard, any chance you're still there?
Jensen, my God! You've been offline for days. Where the hell are you?
I was hoping you'd tell me.
I'm pinging you now. You're in Singapore. Something's wrong, Jensen. I pinged you, and a second later, I lost your GPL signal. It's like you disappeared into a black hole.
Gotta be a jammer.
Well, obviously. If you can find the transmitter and take it offline, I'll be able to track you. And keep you on a tighter leash.
I've got more important things to do than help you keep tabs on me. If Megan and her team are here, there's no time to waste.
I'm sure she was probably barking orders at him again. Looks like this show is packed with A-listers now. The question is, who's headlining?
Things will be a lot easier if Daryl was still around. Anyway, I better get back to storage in case he decides to spring a surprise inspection on us.
Good idea.
Please, please don't leave me like this. No hope. Can't take anymore.
Quite the house of horrors you got here, Doc. You letting anyone in, or just women?
Who are you? How'd you get down here? This is a restricted area.
Obviously. You wouldn't want the rank and file knowing what kind of sick experimentation is going on down here.
No, you don't understand. I'm not. And who the fuck are you?
The name's Jensen. I came here looking for someone. Megan Reed.
Reed? I've seen her research. Gary thinks it could be the key we're missing.
Megan Reed was kidnapped, Kavanaugh. Violently. As was her entire scientific team and the dozens of women you've been torturing down here.
No! You don't understand. I'm trying to save them. Gary and I, we were sent here to put the OCM project back on track. It wasn't until we got here that we realized what that meant, and by then it was too late.
What's OCM stand for?
Organic Computational Matrix. It's a means of cross-connecting living brain tissue and artificial intelligence systems to create a supercomputer of unparalleled capability. Part flesh, part silicon.
That's what you're doing down here, turning prisoners into computer parts.
Human brain activity has to be integrated with the technology, or else it won't work. Even DARPA knew that.
What does DARPA have to do with this?
Nothing. Not directly. In 2007, they started looking for research partners to help develop an artificial cognitive science program that could increase a soldier's situational awareness in the field. a number of private sector companies submitted proposals.
Bell Tower being one of them.
No. Bell Tower was a private military corporation. DARPA wanted researchers. But one of the companies who did submit something was a biotech corporation that deals with Bell Tower. And they believed a successful program could be designed if it could be wired directly into the soldiers' brains. DARPA wasn't willing to go that far.
So this biotech company took the idea to Bell Tower.
A corporation that, being privately funded, doesn't have to concern itself with political or ethical debate.
Just how many prisoners are being wired into this thing?
I don't know. But a lot of them don't seem to survive for more than a year. I've told the others there's no way this project can stay viable with these kinds of numbers. But the OCM computers have to have them to work.
Computers? You mean there's more than one of them?
There's several. This is just where the process starts, the factory floor. We select the candidates here, implant them, and ship them to the other locations. It's all very efficient.
Yeah, except your candidates keep dying. You seem to think Megan's research is integral to salvaging this project of yours. Why?
It's not my project. Had I known before I came here...
Right, just answer the question.
We're experiencing cross-systemic failures with the tech. Over time, subjects implanted with OCM augmentations suffer complete neurological breakdown. They pretty much burn up from the inside. Gary thinks it's a problem with the acceptance of the P-dot array.
I've heard that phrase before.
It's the building block of modern neuro-augmentations. Dr. Reed's been reshaping it, changing the way it bonds with living tissue. The mutagenic gene combination she's introduced into it, well, frankly, it's astonishing.
Enough to warrant her kidnapping? So she'd be forced to work on this project with you?
She's not on this project. I don't know what she's doing or where she is.
You're really gonna stand there and try to justify your role in this, aren't you? People are being enslaved, Kavanaugh. Enslaved and crucified.
It wasn't like that at first. I thought we were gonna make a difference, do something incredible for the world.
Right. And look how incredible it turned out to be. But you can still make a difference, Doctor. You can help me blow the lid off this place.
Are you insane? I can't. There's too much money invested in this. The people I work for, they'll kill me. They'll hunt me down and kill me.
I know people who can protect you, hide you. Interpol is just waiting for evidence to tear Bell Tower apart.
It's not just Bell Tower. Oh, God. Oh, God, am I really gonna do this?
You gather as much evidence as you can carry.
Oh, my God. I'm really gonna do this.
Damn right you are. Now get moving. I'll contact you when I unlock the hatch.
All right, fine. But, Mr. Jensen, please, hurry.
What do you want? I told you people not to barge in here. Wasn't the new biochip design enough?
Dr. Koss, I'm here to get you out.
Jensen? From Sarif? But we were told we'd been written off.
Not exactly.
Listen, Jensen. They forced me to work for them. I didn't want to create the new biochip, especially since it was based on Sarif's research, but they didn't give me a choice.
No one doubts your loyalty, Dr. Koss. Do you know what they plan to do with this new biochip?
I'm not sure. They said something about having Tai Young Medical produce it and distribute it through Lim, but I can't be sure.
I know, and I'm here to bring you all back. But to reach Megan, I need you, Colvin, and Faraday to stage lab accidents as a distraction, simultaneously.
Isn't that a little risky? Besides, how will we coordinate these accidents? It's impossible.
Maybe not. But it's that or staying here and eventually ending up like Dr. Savchenko.
They killed him, didn't they? He kept provoking them, coming up with these wild escape plans. They try to keep us apart as much as possible now. All right, Mr. Jensen. I'm with you. What's our next move?
We need to disable their GPL tracker. I know Dr. Savchenko was working on something.
Yes, a virus program. We all thought it was too risky considering we had nowhere to go. But I don't have it. You'd better check with Nia or Declan.
Declan, right. Dr. Koss, do you have any idea where they're keeping him?
I might. I overheard some of the guards. I think he might be working in the basement of the biomech labs. But I'm not sure. Adam? Adam Jensen? Good grief, lad. What the blazes happened to you?
I made the mistake of surviving. I'm here to get you out, Dr. Faraday.
I told Vasily that Sarif wouldn't stop looking.
Sevchenko's dead, Dr. Faraday. I'm sorry.
I figured as much.
I've got a plan to distract the guards. 3 lab accidents.
I like your style, son. And it just might work if you can get Nia and Eric to agree. But timing them to occur at once, that will be the trick.
I'll worry about the timing. For now, sit tight and wait for my signal.
Go on, lad. Let's put this plan of yours into action. It's time to teach these wankers a lesson.
Your tenacity, Adam Jensen, is really quite irritating. We'd like you to stop now.
I'm afraid I can't, Zao. You see, I figured it out. I know what you and your conspiracy buddies are planning.
Do you? How clever.
A new biochip. A software upgrade that limits what augmentations can do. You're creating a kill switch. You kidnapped Megan Reed's team to do it, and you're seizing control of the market to ensure it gets distributed. All because you're afraid of people like me. Augmented people, with the power to resist you.
No one's afraid of you, Mr. Jensen. All your blundering around and childish interference hasn't stopped a thing. Tell me, have you been to a limb clinic lately?
Let me guess. That was supposed to shut me down, right? Leave me broken and begging?
The Augs were recalled! You should be offline!
Women never fail to underestimate men.
You should have stayed dead, Jensen.
Goodbye, my friend. She's lost to you. Right over here.
Is that you?
Not exactly.
Adam? Oh my God, Adam!
It's you.
You're hurt. What happened?
What happened to you? I risked my life for you, Megan. I came halfway around the world, and for what?
It's not what you think.
Are you part of this?
No! No, Adam, I swear it! The kidnapping was real. The attack on Sarif Industries? They came after me. They wanted my research.
And when did you decide they could have it?
It didn't happen like that. I wanted to tell you, but I couldn't. I couldn't! And then David said we had to use it. We owed it to mankind.
David? What are you talking about?
My great discovery. The genetic framework I found that makes it easier for living tissue to bond with implants. I found it. In you, Adam. I used your DNA. I wanted to tell you, I swear. But David convinced me what it could mean for mankind. How much better off we could all be. It took Hugh to make me see how wrong I was.
Hugh? Hugh Darrow.
He owns this facility. After Namir brought us here...
Richard! Patch me into Sarif, now!
Adam, please! He was only pretending to work with Tai Young and the others. He found out what they were planning to do and told them he would help. But only to make sure they never succeeded. Their control signal won't work.
Thank you, David. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Sarif here has asked me to show the world how human enhancement technology can change it. After careful deliberation, I've decided I must do exactly that. Forgive me.
Modified the control signal. Anyone with a new biochip will be affected. Hugh never said anything about this.
I'm going back for the scientists.
No, Adam! I know the complex better than you. I'll find them. There's a hangar bay through there. Get to its control room and retract the roof. Clear a path for us.
Thank God you came. I've got wounded here. We'll have to move them first.
We can't move anyone yet. Not until I get to the base of the station and shut down Darrow's broadcast.
What? Why?
The chaos you experienced here, it's everywhere. The Illuminati created a biochip that stops people from using enhanced abilities, and Darrow turned it into a kill switch.
Oh my God, you. We gotta fix this, Adam. If people realize what's happened, if they believe augmentation technology created this chaos, they'll ban human enhancement research forever.
And that would be a bad thing.
Yes, it would! Don't you see what's at stake here? Ever since man first crawled out of that ocean, we've been striving to be more than we are. Augmentation technology is just the latest, greatest step on a very long road. But we've barely scratched the surface of its potential. We can't let fear stop us from continuing.
That's your belief, Sarif. Not everyone shares it.
But you do, Adam. I know it. And if we work together, we can really make a difference. We can improve the lives of everyone. Some people will be left behind. It's reality. It's evolution, son.
Right. Evolution based on my DNA.
Please, son, you have to stay with me on this.
You experimented with my DNA without telling me.
Adam, this is difficult. Listen, Megan came to me with the sample. When she showed me her finding, when we saw the incredible potential of super compatibility,
you just had to share it with the world.
Adam, think about it. Would you have been able to do any of the things you've done without enhancements? Huh? Most people's bodies aren't as accepting of this technology as yours is. Sharing your DNA makes it possible for us to be like you. How can you deny us that chance?
Who said I would deny it? You stole my DNA and lied to me. You didn't give me the choice.
I'm giving it to you now, Adam. Look, I admit it, I haven't done things the best way. But don't punish the world to spite me. Darrow wants us to live in the Dark Ages. The Illuminati wants to limit evolution to those they control. You and me, we...
Don't group me with you, Sarif. I'll make my own choices from here.
I believe that, son. And I believe you make the right ones.
Jensen. Jensen, can you read me?
Barely. I've reached Panchaya, Richard. Any word from Sarah for the UN delegates?
Nothing. The installation went into lockdown shortly after Darrow gave his speech. I can't tell if anyone's even alive. And the signal's still broadcasting.
Meaning no one's safe till I get in there and shut it down.
You'll have to disengage the lockdown first. Look for a master control panel at the top of the tower.
I don't think you want to do that, Mr. Jensen. Disengage lockdown, and whatever demons this station contains are likely to come crashing out on us.
Afraid to die, Darrow? Or just unwilling to face what you've done?
Oh, I know what I've done, believe me. I take no pleasure in it.
And yet you still did it.
I did what had to be done. 20 years ago, I gave the world augmentation technology. I thought I was giving it a bright future, but instead I gave it the means to destroy itself. No law, no UN regulation was going to fix that.
People are dying out there. Hundreds of thousands of people driven to the brink of insanity because of you.
I had to convince the world. Before today, people believed we should steal fire from the gods and redesign human nature. Human nature is the only thing we have that gives us a moral compass and the social skills we need to live in peace. Destroy it, and you destroy our very species.
Don't paint yourself a savior in this. What you're doing is insane.
Is it? When this is done, the Illuminati won't be able to control men and women like you as they had planned, from the inside out. No one will be able to use the technology I invented to make others into beings they desire. Something we both know has happened already.
You think you're Frankenstein? Killing his own monster?
Actually, Mr. Jensen, I prefer to think of myself as Daedalus, watching helplessly as his child crashes into the sea.
You designed that system, Darrow. You can tell me how to shut it down.
But I won't. You think what I'm doing is extreme. You simply don't understand. For humanity to survive beyond this century, it must abandon ill-conceived notions about transcendence and embrace change. But for that to happen, the hard lesson must be learned. Blood must be shed.
What you're doing is horrific. It has to stop. You can't force people to change. They have to do it on their own, or they'll end up resenting you for it. And doing it like this? My God, Darrow, it's insane.
It is not insane, Mr. Jensen. Tragic, yes. Unavoidable? No. You, of all people, should be able to understand this. In your former career, were you not sometimes called upon to kill in the line of duty, to carry that grim responsibility in order to save others? You must realize this is no different. Only the scale has changed. Because the threat we face as a species is so extreme.
You've convinced yourself you're right, but whatever moral high ground you're standing on is nothing but a stack of innocent victims. You're trying to justify genocide. All your talk about ethics and ideals doesn't mean a damn compared to that.
Genocide? I'm trying to save our species, and you keep twisting my words. It was my genius that created the technology, my vision that seduced Sarif and Zhao and all the others who now feed off of it. They seek to stand on the shoulders of my research without comprehending the danger that people like you pose to mankind. I am the only one with the perspective, the insight, to know what is needed.
People like me, you're not interested in saving humanity, Darrow, no matter how loud you shout it. This is about jealousy, pure and simple. Everything you're doing today is in service to your wounded ego, because you can't stand anyone leaving you behind.
And who better to know ego and jealousy than you, eh, Mr. Jensen? You and I, we're two sides of the same coin. I could have been you if it weren't for this damned blood in my veins. But I was cheated by my own DNA, cursed to become a cripple. And I am not the only one. As long as this technology exists, mankind will continue to divide. Help me make us all equal again.
You cover it up with all that pretense about saving the world, trying to justify it. But deep down inside, you're nothing more than an angry child. Spiteful, full of hate, envious, and bitter. How petty is that?
Petty? I was betrayed by my own genetics, ruined by my own flesh. What right do you have to condemn me? To curse me? All I ever wanted was to build something good. Something magnificent. And now, there's so much blood. So much blood. I will give you what you want, Mr. Jensen. Codes to shut down Panchaea's security system. But you'll still be in danger. Much of the system is self-determining and lethal. When you see it, maybe then you'll understand. The technology I created will not be the future any one of us desires. Please, help the world understand that.
What the hell? Zao, what are you doing?
Connecting to Panchaea's Hiron project, Mr. Jensen. The most advanced quantum computer slave to the human brain, and the closest to perfection we'll ever achieve. I'm going to use it to hack Darrow's signal and rework the message to our benefit.
Our benefit? You mean the Illuminati's?
Someone has to override the signal and be the world's savior. And let's be honest, neither of us would trust anyone else to fill that role. Computer, begin EEG sync.
So much pain. Sinking beta waves at 40 cycles per second.
Sleep, please. Let me sleep.
Incompatible master-slave.
Why can't I wake up?
Alert. Unable to transfer control to Alpha Pod.
The system won't recognize my chip.
Neural systems offline. Rerouting control of the
energy. I can't control Iron!
Increasing glitter maintenance by 32%.
Sal, get them out of there. I have to reach the control chamber.
No! I can feel control! I can control!
Stop the signal! Security alert.
Through the primary control
pad. Oh, shit.
Look at what people done! I don't like it here!
2 access hatch is open. Pod 2, safety purge complete. Warning. Pod 3, safety purge in progress. Stand by. Contamination warning. Pod 3, access hatch is open.
No!
Mr. Jensen, how ironic that you should be the one to save us from the monsters out there.
Monsters, Taggart? You mean people. Augmented people who've lost all control, lost their reason.
Isn't that supposed to be my line? Unfortunately, it seems your esteemed Mr. Darrow decided to appropriate my point and turn it back on me. In madness and in blood. He has betrayed us all.
So you finally admit it. You are part of this, after all. You have been all along.
It would be pointless to deny anything now, but despite what you think of us, we never wanted augmentations outlawed. All we've ever sought is regulation, rules governing how the technology is developed, and laws that ensure it's used for the good of society.
You've raised society above humanity. So who gets to make those rules?
Men with wisdom, strength, and tenacity to know what's right. Proven leaders who distinguish themselves, like you, Mr. Jensen. You've certainly earned the right to be one of us.
You and your cabal.
Perhaps. But all we sought was a safety valve, Mr. Jensen. A means of making sure the world would never spin out of control. The potential of this technology is great, but as we've seen, its potential for destruction is even greater.
Your doomsday scenario doesn't impress me. You'd say anything to stay in power.
Do you think humanity will simply police itself? We do not live in some Eden, Mr. Jensen. Or are you that much like your boss, David Sarif, who envisions a world where everyone is enhanced and suddenly they all love each other? There will always be a need for methods of control. There are organizations already in place that are better equipped to handle certain things. The UN, for instance.
Reimagined, no doubt.
At least somewhat. And this technology will be a great part of it. Imagine, Mr. Jensen, a world governed by common principles. The end to international power struggles, to terrorism. These things can be accomplished if you join us.
I'm not looking for glory, Taggart.
Just remember that without control, there's no room for freedom, only anarchy. You were a policeman once. You know the importance of order.
I know there's a difference between order and slavery.
The biochip wasn't supposed to force people to do anything. It merely limited power so that people couldn't go on killing sprees like the ones taking place right now.
Amazing how well that worked out.
Say what you will, but I know that some part of you agrees with me. Absolute freedom is no different than absolute chaos. Society needs boundaries if it has any hope of surviving. And you, Mr. Jensen, can be the one to give us that hope. Shut down Darrow's signal. Then help me get a message out saying that an accident at VersaLife contaminated the world's neuropazine supply.
VersaLife? And what if I decided to blame the Illuminati?
The Illuminati is just a name to get rich financiers to invest more money. Besides, do you really think the world will believe in some 18th century conspiracy theory? Do this for us, and you'll ensure a future for mankind, all of mankind, augmented or otherwise. The future Hugh Darrow offers doesn't allow for both.
Let me think about it. Freedom. To those who don't have it, it's more valuable than gold. But where should it start and end? We humans often think we have the right to expand, absorb, convert, or possess anything we need to reach our dreams. But time and time again, hasn't this led to conflicts with others who essentially believe the same thing? Looking back on the challenges I faced,
at the way I often resolve them, I realize morality can become our saving grace. Most of the time, didn't I try to keep my values in mind, knowing how my actions would affect others? More often than not, I resisted the urge to abuse power and resources simply to reach my goals more swiftly. I managed to hang on to my humanity. But the temptation to ignore it was always there. It's that temptation that so worries Taggart. He's not afraid of freedom. He's afraid of the chaos that erupts when individuals have nothing but morality to constrain them. He wants us to regulate enhancement technologies because he fears all that power without limits, without guide rails to keep us from abusing it. Absolute freedom is no better than chaos. Society needs laws and regulations to protect it. So if the men and women behind Taggart need to work in the shadows, pulling strings to enable us to head in a safe direction, will supporting them be all that bad? If they're as wise as Taggart says, how bad will their leadership be? I just hope they stand by what they say. Sarif was right about one thing. It's in our nature to want to rise above our limits. Think about it. We were cold, so we harnessed fire. We were weak, so we invented tools. Every time we met an obstacle, we used creativity and ingenuity to overcome it. The cycle is inevitable. But will the outcome always be good? I guess that will depend on how we approach it. In the past, we've had to compensate for weaknesses, finding quick solutions that only benefit a few. But what if we never need to feel weak or morally conflicted again? What if the path Sarif wants us to take enables us to hold on to higher values with more stability? One thing is obvious. For the first time in history, we have a chance to steal fire from the gods. To turn away from it now, to stop pursuing a future in which technology and biology combine, leading to the promise of a singularity, would mean to deny the very essence of who we are. No doubt the road to get there will be bumpy, hurting some people along the way. But won't achieving the dream be worth it? We can become the gods we've always been striving to be. We might as well get good at it.
You worry too much, Morgan. There's nothing we can't manage given time. She's here. I have to cut this short. Keep going through the wreckage. Maybe we'll find something we can use for the Morpheus Initiative. Come in! Dr. Reed, we're so pleased you decided to join us.
Where else could I go?
No regrets, my dear. As Ariadne told Theseus before he entered the Minotaur's labyrinth, always forward, never left or right. You'll be very interested in our current project. We're breaking new ground.
Yes, the nanite virus chimera is quite intriguing. I'm looking forward to seeing the hybrid project up close, Mr. Page.
And so you shall. But please, call me Bob.